Welcome in AgriFunda Digital Agriculture Classes. Please like, share and subscribe my channel and click that bell button right next to it to get notified whenever I post new videos. Now we are going to discuss soils of India, classification and characteristics of soil. Soils of India. There are various types of soil found in India. The major forms of soil which are found in India are these: alluvial soil, red soil, black soil, laterite soil, desert arid soil, peaty and marshy soil, forest soil, mountain soil, tarai soil, saline and alkaline soil. Soil classification. In India, soil had been classified from the ancient period itself, even though it was not as detailed as the modern classification. In the ancient period, the classification was based only on two things: whether the soil is fertile or sterile, that means non-fertile. Thus, the classification were urvara, that means fertile, uzra, that means sterile or non-fertile. In the modern period, when men started to know about the various characteristics of soil, they begin to classify soil on the basis of texture, color and moisture, etc. When the Soil Survey of India were established in 1956, they studied soil of India and their characteristics. In the graph, we can see that green portion represents the forest and mountain area. Bluish green colored portion shows alluvial soil. The red lined portion shows red and yellow soil. Bluish colored portion shows black soil. Orange portion shows laterite soil, whereas yellow portion shows arid soil. Alluvial soil. This is mostly available soil in India, about 43%, which covers an area about 143 square kilometer, widespread in the northern plains and river valleys. In peninsular India, they are mostly found in deltas, estuaries. Humus, lime and organic matter are mainly present in alluvial soil. This is highly fertile soil. This is found in the Indus, Ganga, Brahmaputra plain, Narmada, Tapi plain, etc. They are depositional soil, transported and deposited by rivers and streams, etc. Sand content decreases from west to east of country. New alluvium is termed as khadar and old alluvium is termed as bhangar. The color of alluvial soil is light gray to ash gray. Texture of alluvial soil is sandy to silty loam or clay. This is rich in potash, whereas poor in phosphorus. Wheat, rice, maize, sugarcane, pulses, oil seeds, etc. are cultivated mainly in alluvial soil. Now let us discuss red soil, seen mainly in low rainfall areas, also known as omnibus group. This is porous, friable structure and light textured. Absence of lime, kunkar, that means impure calcium carbonate. Red soil is deficient in lime, phosphate, manganese, nitrogen, humus and potash. The color of red soil is red because of ferric oxide. The lower layer is reddish yellow or yellow. Texture of red soil is sandy to clayey and loamy. Wheat, cotton, pulses, tobacco, oil seeds, potato, etc. are cultivated mainly in red soil. Now let us discuss black or regur soil. Here, regur means cotton. The best soil for cotton is black soil. Most of the Deccan is occupied by black soil. This is mature soil. High water retaining capacity is present in black soil. Black soil swells and will become sticky when wet, whereas it shrinks when dried. Self-ploughing is a characteristic of black soil as it develops wide cracks when dried. Black soil is rich in iron, lime, calcium, potassium, aluminium and magnesium. But this is deficient in nitrogen, phosphorus and organic matter. Color of black soil is deep black to light black and the texture is clay. Now let us discuss laterite soil. Name from Latin word later, which means brick. Become so soft when wet and so hard when dried out. found in the areas of high temperature and high rainfall and formed as a result of high leaching. Lime and silica will be leached away from the soil. Organic matter of soil will be removed fast by the bacteria as it is high temperature, and humus will be taken quickly by the trees and other plants. Thus, humus content is low in laterite soil. This is rich in iron and aluminium, whereas deficient in nitrogen, potash, potassium, lime and humus. Color is red due to iron oxide. Rice, ragi, sugarcane and cashew nut are cultivated mainly in laterite soil. Desert or arid soil. Seen under arid and semi-arid conditions, deposited mainly by wind activities. Salt content is very high in desert soil. There is lack of moisture and humus. Kunkar or impure calcium carbonate content is high, which restricts the infiltration of water. Nitrogen is insufficient and phosphate is normal. Texture of desert soil is mainly sandy and the color is brown to red, or can be said as red to brown. Peaty or marshy soil. Areas of heavy rainfall and high humidity mainly contains these kind of soil. Growth of vegetation is very less in peaty and marshy soil. A large quantity of dead organic matter, humus, which makes the soil alkaline. Heavy soil and black in color. Forest soil, found mainly in the regions of high rainfall. Humus content is very less, thus the soil is acidic in nature. Mountain soil, found mainly in the region of mountains. Immature soil and very low humus and acidic in nature. Tarai soil. Tarai soil have a wet regime. It is a foothill soil and extend in strips of varying width at the foots of Himalayas in Jammu and Kashmir, Uttarakhand, Himachal Pradesh, UP and West Bengal. Soil under natural condition are thickly vegetated and swampy. Saline and alkaline soil. This is mainly developed in the area of arid or semi-arid regions. Poor drainage is responsible for the development of saline and alkaline soil. These are mainly found in the black soil region in south and west, in Indo-Gangetic alluvium, in north and in deltic regions. Thank you. Please subscribe my channel so that you will be get notified whenever I post new video. Please click that bell icon and please visit description box to get some more videos related to soil.